This is the application for the Tapo D225 video doorbell. Here we can see on our main Tapo page under favorites, I have a little widget for it. It will also show up under all devices or camera. Right here, we have a quick toggle to enter privacy mode. Selecting that means the camera is in privacy mode now. So if I open that up, camera feed is not actually going to show me anything. I'm going to turn that back on while I finish talking. The icon is changeable. And then down here, you see location, front door, and then a small battery percentage, letting you know how much battery is left for the camera. If you had this hardwired in, that would show you that it was hardwired in. Selecting the camera itself will open up the feed. We'll just let that roll so that it's waking up. Here you could see the full view of the camera. Up here at the top, we have the name of the camera, its network status, and battery percentage. Here you can see kind of toggling on and off in these corners. That is tagging. I will show you that down there a little later. In fact, we're just going to turn that off so it's not quite as distracting while we're talking. If I tap on the video feed itself, it will give us some options. First being, if I select this, it will allow me to add up to 4 other Tapo cameras in this view and load them up. So from here, I would have to select my other Tapo camera. So I will select that one and say add. And this one I know is on. This one is currently in privacy mode. But if I swipe, I can add another set of 4. And you can add several sets of 4 for viewing in that way. Tapping my primary camera again, I can select the square, and that will bring it down to a single view. Right here, we have a quick toggle for the 2K video quality, 960 or auto. I like to have it on the maximum I can while testing. So we're just gonna hit that X right there. Next, we have auto, and this is for our night mode. So we can have auto switching back and forth between day and night, forced night, and forced day mode all the time. Turn that off. Here, if I select that, we'll make this full screen. Over here, we have a camera image. If I select that, what that's going to do is take a still image of whatever the camera happens to see in frame right at this second. We have our video camera right there that is going to record any action that is happening live in the feed for you to download later. Simply tap it to stop it. So the right of that, we have our volume controls. Right here, you could see doorbell microphone volume. Now, you can crank this all the way up if you wanted to, but muting it and then unmuting it will always put it back to its default, and all of the audio recordings that I was testing were at the microphone's default setting. And then right here, we have our talk. So we have mic is on, mic is off, tap to call, and then speaker on and speaker off. If I tap to call, what this is going to do is start a call with the doorbell, and anybody who's outside will hear me talking. Hanging up the phone call will end the conversation. Over here in the corner, we have options for the doorbell microphone volume as well as the speaker volume. And I will say the speaker is rather good with this doorbell. Coming down, we have our talk. This is push to talk, so talking while you hold a button, as opposed to the call conversation where you don't have to hold the button down. And then right here, we have the quick toggles for those settings that we saw before. Privacy mode, you saw me toggle that from the exterior of the application. That will turn it off so that the camera no longer sees anything that's going on. Quick responses, right here, selecting this will allow you to send quick responses through your video doorbell, including the creation of custom quick responses, as you can see here. Selecting the sprocket icon in the upper right-hand corner brings me to the doorbell information, which we get to a little later, but right here you could see auto responses off. If I turn that on, it gives me options as to how I would like them to function, but I'll show you that a little later. And here we have edit voice response. Can I edit any of the ones that I've set up already? But I can create a custom. I would press and hold, and that would give me a custom voice response. But let me show you what these actually sound like.
No one can answer the door right now. We are notified you stopped by. Please leave the item by the door. I'll be there in a minute. Sorry, not interested. You are trespassing. Police have been notified.
Hey, you kids, get off my lawn. What are you looking at? Go away. It says no trespassing.
Coming down, we have our light. Selecting this will light up the push button LED. So it doesn't actually have LEDs on it, but rather the button itself will go to its white state and turn itself on for a 5-minute period of time in battery mode. Yes, everything I'm showing you is for the battery mode, but it will make it so that you don't have IR lights, and it will show you who's in front of the camera in color. Tag on and off. You saw me turn that off before. What this will do is tag things like vehicles, pets, as they walk through frame. Right here, you can see it's automatically tagging vehicles. The bush is giving it a little trouble right there, but when I do walk in front of this as myself, you could see that it does tag me as a person. And here we've got a vehicle. So you will actually see that it will tag a moving vehicle. Moving on, Tapo Care. This is the paid service that Tapo has for their cameras. The beauty of Tapo products is that you don't actually need the Tapo Care for their video cameras, and Doorbell in particular, to be functional, unlike some competitors. If I open up Tapo Care, it's going to show us, well, there's a bunch of flash sales, but here is your monthly and your yearly subscription. Do note that right now it is saying first year only. What do you get with Tapo Care? 30 days unlimited cloud storage. You get rich notifications, which is the only reason that I would consider it, which is when I swipe down, instead of seeing a thumbnail, I just get it like a notification text. And then smart sort, so classified cloud videos based on more detected events, so there's like filters and things like that. But you don't need Tapo Care in order for the camera to be functional in any way, shape, or form. And then down here you can see there's a 30-day free trial when you sign up or purchase a new product. You can X that off, and I'll just say, got it, I can always get it later. Just know that everything that I've been showing you is without the Tapo Care. And then right down here at the bottom, this is our playback and downloads area. This is where you can actually see your events, and I'm just going to pause that right now. What I like about Tapo is you can pinch to zoom in on this timeline, and then notice events are color-coded for actions that have happened with them. So that was me kind of pushing the doorbell. There's a vehicle, person, lots of things that you can do. You can, in the upper right-hand corner of any of your video events, adjust the speed, but sadly that only works when it is playing. So you can go down to 1/16th or all the way up to 16 speed. You can turn off the sound from the recording. You can take a snapshot of the recording, much like you could with the live feed. Same thing with the video camera. If I select that, I can record right from this recording what I'm seeing. And if I come over to this event here with the car, if I select the scissor icon, this is one of the great things that Tapo allows you to do, in that here, this is the full length of this clip. Well, maybe I just want the car coming into my driveway. I can adjust the timeline here. So I can make this larger, I can make this smaller. And then once I get the clip to the size that I want, I can download the clip. So that is a very useful feature. Here, this will make the video recording larger. And then down here we have local storage, great thing about Tapo, and then cloud if we had it. We also have a calendar of events right here. Every blue dot indicates something that has happened, and you can move through the calendar like that. To download any of these events, you simply select the three dots in the right-hand corner here, and then select download, and that will add this to your downloads area, which as you can see right now, we're on playback, but up here, this is our downloads, and these are all the things that I've downloaded while I've been testing this. So lots of footage to go through. That is everything that we can do for camera controls for the doorbell. In the upper right-hand corner here, if I select this, these are our actual settings for the doorbell. So there's a lot more that we can do here. Starting off at the top, we have our doorbell name. If I select device information, that's how you can change the name, location, things of that nature. But there's also a lot of sensitive information in there, so I'm not going to show you that. Over here on the left, we have detections. Notice it has a bunch of different pictures. So scrolling down, I have general motion turned off, but I have person detection turned on, pet detection turned on, vehicle turned on, and package detection turned on. The one thing I will say is with vehicle detection, if you are facing a road like I am, you may want to either lower your sensitivity or turn it off completely because, well, I get lots of notifications when I was testing this. If we move up to the top, we have wake up settings. So event detected. So when will it actually start recording? When it detects motion, which is using that PIR sensor, or doorbell press. And then we have our sensitivity. Coming down, since I went all the way down to the bottom really quickly because I was excited about that, we have our detection zones. Notice this is turned on for all of these detection types in one zone. But if I wanted to, I could set one up for each, and they're color-coded. Maybe for cars, so if I come over to vehicle, maybe for vehicle, I only care about my neighbor's driveway, my driveway, and the little bit in front of my house. I can save that. Notice that each of them is set for the entire visible space when you first start. So pets, well, pets, I don't care about this part here because that's the only part a pet should be able to get to. And I cut out all that space up there. But you can see, I can add a zone, I can delete a zone, I can clear the zone, or I could save what I'm working on. I'm going to confirm that I'm saving that for my pets. And I'm just gonna go back to all, notice it grays everybody out, and there we go. So that is our detection settings. Over here, we have power options. Right now I'm on battery, so I have show battery status and then show battery percent. Here is where you can select your power supply. So in my case, it's battery or it's hardwired. Do not think that just because you plug in the USB-C, it will allow you to be hardwired. I tried it, it doesn't work. Has to be tapped into actual low voltage. Wake up settings, we showed this before. Event detection, doorbell press, and then sensitivity. Coming down, we have our working mode. Right now I have it on balanced, but you can have high performance, power saving, and custom, and then auto power saving mode. If I select power saving, it gives you information as to what it's gonna do. Reduce the recordings. I can do custom, which will allow me to make changes in my custom settings. So here I go, what I want. Retrigger time, record buffer, maximum clip length. That's all the things that you can do if you select custom setting. I keep it in balanced. It gives me just about what I need. If you go up to high performance, the battery might drain itself a little quicker, but it's gonna be better for surveillance. Coming down, we have auto privacy mode. I have that currently turned off. If you enable auto privacy mode, it will turn on automatically every time you charge the camera. So that's actually a great feature because you don't want it recording while it's in the house. And then here we have our battery levels. Well, this is over the last 7 days for me for testing. If I drag it out to 30 days, you could see charge, degrade, 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 charge, and I'm degrading it once again. And that's me really thoroughly testing this. If I come down here, we have our battery usage. It's letting you know in a chart, hey, it's using this much. If I come back to the 30 days, you get a 30-day chart for that information as well. Very helpful. And then time of usage on August 19th is 1 hour and 6 minutes. So you can see that's the amount of triggers that I get. And then coming down, we have details, 5 minutes, wake events. Like there's just so much information in here. And I love that. I really do. I like having lots of information. Coming down, we have doorbell. It is currently on. I can select this and we can either turn it on or off. We can lower and raise the volume. And then we have a selection of doorbell rings. Coming back, we have paired. I have it paired to the chime that came with it, but also to a smart hub. And then we have effective time. So I can do this all day during the day, which is 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. during the night, 8 p.m. to 8 a.m. and then a custom schedule. So hypothetically, if there's certain times of day that you want the ring to actually ring or not ring, you can do that. And that is a great feature because I enjoy customization. I just wish that they had a snooze button to like, let me snooze it for a short period of time. Maybe in a firmware update. Coming down, we have video doorbell call, on or off. This is one of the great features that the Tapo D225 has that other doorbells wish they thought of first, in that it brings you right into the conversation mode when you get a notification, rather than, hey, somebody's at your door, open it, see the event, go to the live feed, start the conversation. No, you open your notification and you're right in conversation mode, like this.
Quick response for notification. Look at that. Call on the phone. So I can end the call, do a voice call, or do a quick response right from here.
Coming down, we have spoken language. By default, for me, it's in English, but you have lots of choices, as you can see there. Auto response, you could turn that on or off. If you turn on auto response, your response time is 5 seconds, 1 second, all the way up to 30 seconds, and then you can select what you want it to say. So if somebody's loitering at your door, 5 seconds, get off my property, go away. Here we have our anti-theft alarm. When turned on, if somebody takes your doorbell, it's gonna make it very obvious that they shouldn't have it and they need to put it back, which looks like this.
We're gonna put you down.
You have been recorded and the host has been notified. Please return the doorbell immediately.
So couldn't quite do that one-handed.
Coming down, we have another location for our Tapo Care free trial. Next, we have our storage and recordings. If I select this, this is gonna show me local recording, great SD card in the camera. Local storage, it's gonna tell you the health of your storage. So right here, you can see I'm doing okay on my SD card. Keep in mind, if you have this plugged in to those hot wires, you will be able to have 24/7 recording, not just clips like I have with the battery. And in my case, I have it loop recording because when I get to the end, I want it to go back and record over those previous clips. Keep in mind, if you're doing the 24/7 recording, you also want to make sure that you do loop unless you want to be replacing your SD card. Coming down, we have our clip settings. This I kind of showed you before, where we have retrigger time, recording buffer, and then maximum clip length. If you change any one of these, it will automatically change the camera into custom mode as opposed to balance mode or high performance, whatever you have. You also have recording schedule. Right now I have detection recording and don't record. If I wanted to, I would come up here and we would say, yeah, these things I don't want to record during these times of day. I actually want it recording, so I'm not going to mess with that. And then record sound. If you live in an area where you're not allowed to record somebody's audio, this is how you can come in and turn that off. Moving down, we have our video display. Night mode, we have infrared mode, as you can see here, classic black and white. We have full color mode, turns on a spotlight to see in color mode. And then we have doorbell mode, which is turn on a spotlight when somebody comes. So this one, as somebody approaches and it recognizes it's a person, it will turn an LED on, which again is that button. Or we have full color mode, which will constantly use the LED light, which will definitely use your battery much faster. And then here we have viewing distance, near, medium, far. The longer viewing distance will reduce battery life. So if you go up there, it's gonna really power those IR lights. Coming back, we have video quality. We touched on that in the quick toggle. 2K, 960, or auto, which will switch depending on your bandwidth. Frame rate, not bad. 15 frames a second or up to 20 frames a second. Privacy zones, this is actually very helpful. Hypothetically, over here, this is my neighbor's yard. Maybe I don't necessarily want to see them coming in and out of their house. I respect their privacy. If I select this as a privacy zone, and then select this check mark, this will become a black square. That black square is not visible in recordings, in live feed, and they maintain their privacy. And you can have several privacy zones set up on a single video feed. Coming down, we have our on-screen display information. I like display timestamp. This is the format that the timestamp would be in. You can display text. In this case right now, it's D225. But if you had this in docking bay 3 and had several different cameras, you can label them as such. And then I always display the logo because I like to know what camera my video feeds are coming from. Down here, we have display tag on or off. So this is speed right there, you can see. And then if I do this, it puts a live. I like how they show you exactly how it's gonna look in your camera feed, to the point where I actually get confused and click on the wrong back button. Coming down, we have our spotlight settings. Selecting this, well, again, it's that button. I have it set to the maximum brightness. LED, I have it on auto, but you can select always off or always on, and then you have color choices. I'm not gonna lie, the color choices only show up at night when it's pretty dark. And if you've got the LED spotlight, it automatically defaults it back to white really quickly. I tried taking pictures. They did not come out very well in photo or video. Take my word for it. You get some color options. They're not the greatest. It's a nice feature that they're there, but I wouldn't say that this is the standout reason to get this doorbell. Here you have your network connectivity, privacy mode, enable, disable, tap it right there. Notifications on or off, selecting this. Well, active notifications. Yep, I want to see that. Reach notifications, need Tapo Care, can't use this without. And then types. You can schedule or have it always like I do, which I do, and you can just tap on and off what you want. Advanced settings, here we have power line frequency, 50 hertz or 60 hertz. If you don't know what it is, leave it at its default setting. Voice call mode, we have standard, and then compatibility mode. Compatibility mode will do everything it can to make sure that you have the most stable call quality while using your video camera. Display settings, very similar, hardware acceleration or compatibility mode. Do the best it can to make sure that everything is stable. Diagnostic, on or off right there. I have it off at the moment. You have share device. Do you want to share this device with somebody? Sure. You send them a link. Remember, they need to have their own TP-Link account, and then you can give them general access or administrative access to your doorbell. Smart actions. Well, there is a lot of automation that you can do if you have several other Tapo devices like cameras, doorbell, lights, switches. This is where you would do it. You would press this plus sign and create an automation. When somebody pushes the doorbell, my Tapo lights come on. Great feature if you need that, because you might not hear one of the many placements of the chime box. Here we have our user guide and then feedback. Firmware, if you want to manually check it, you would select that and it will check for firmware. And then we can either reboot our doorbell or remove our doorbell by selecting those options. Coming back, those are all the settings and options that we have for the Tapo D225 video doorbell.